By the end of this video, you will know how to change the color of the shoe, as well as know how to save and reload the shoes for future use in Close3D 2020. To change the shoe color in Close3D, we are going to the avatar, and the avatar right here lists under the library panel. Double click on it to open the folder. Then you come down here into the asset area right below the library panel. Select female underscore V1. Double click on it to open. Then you come down here, hover your mouse over the avatar. And if you look to the right, you see FV1 underscore Kelly. .avt, and we're gonna select her. So double click on it to select. To zoom out, scroll my mouse wheel backward, and to zoom in, I'm scrolling my mouse wheel forward, and now I'm gonna view her to a side view. To do so, press down Alt and right click on your mouse and then drag to the left to view a side view. Now I'm going to select on the shoe. Okay, after the shoe is selected, you come over here and click on this. You see under basic parameters, below there is a texture, and to the right here is a fabric swatch or texture swatch. Click on it one to open. Now the fabric swatch open, it's located in Close user. You see this CAP underscore black. I want you to right click on that, okay? After you right click on that, you come over here to open with, and just hover your mouse over it, and then you see to the right here, Adobe Photoshop 2020. Click on it to open the Photoshop, okay? Now we are here with this texture swatch. So we're gonna go to google.com right here, and we're gonna type in Google image. We are going to get the textile swatches so we can change a shoe color, okay? So click on the Google image, and now you here type in fabrics.com, then press enter, and next come down here to tool, click on it, then come down here to size, and we want to select large, okay, large size, and click on search again to activate the setting that we just did. And you see up here, don't select all these because all these are sponsored like advertised by those fabric.com. We don't want that. We want to scroll down here to get just the image that we can use for a shoe. So scroll down, find the one you like. Since we already set to the large image, any of this image is good. Just get the one that flat surface, okay? No, like this one. Not good. This one's not good. Just select the flat surface one. I'm looking for something a little bit bright color. What about this one? This one looks pretty good. I'm gonna click on that one to enlarge the image on the right hand side here, as you can see. Now you can right click on that image and then go to save image as, okay? Click on it. And name your image. I'm gonna name it star. Okay. And save it under download. And I'm gonna click save. Now the image save. We're gonna go to the image that I saved earlier, which was under download. So go to my PC, then download, click on it. Now this is the image that I saved earlier. So we're gonna right click, and then we're gonna open that. Again, open with, and then select Photoshop. Okay, now our image is in Photoshop. We're gonna crop away the area that we don't want. So go to Crops tool over here on the left hand side. Click on it to select. Now you see this edge appear. You just click on this edge and then drag toward the center to crop the image. You can press enter or click on the check mark right here to confirm. We can click on there. Now we have this perfect image for a shoe color or shoe texture, okay? So be sure to come over here and click over here to unlock. So you can actually move this image to our shoe texture swatch window that we opened earlier, okay? So to move this swatch to the shoe texture, we go to Move tool on the left corner here in Photoshop window. Click on it to select, then come back here. You click on the swatch and then drag. And just drop right over here. When it's turned white like that, that means you're in. You just drop right in here. And now your swatch is in the shoe swatch. We're gonna scale this swatch to have the same size as the shoe swatch, okay? To scale this swatch, we're gonna go Control T to transform tool. And see right here, you just click on this angle right here and drag. You know, in Photoshop function now, you don't have to hold shift to actually drag this shape. If you hold shift, the shape will not come equally scale, okay? We don't want our image to screw. So just click on the pointer here and then drag. No hold down shift, no nothing. If you hold down shift, your image will screw and then snug it. We don't want that. We just click and drag. And now, if it's over to the edge like this, no problem, because you know, as long as it covered the original shoe swatch, we are good. Now, again, we're gonna press enter or the check mark to confirm. And now a star is perfect. It's the same exact size to the texture swatch. And we're gonna export that image back to Chloe user library. To do so, you come up here to File, and then come down here to Export, and we want that to export as, okay? Just leave everything the same. We do not want to change the size nor the quality. Just leave everything the same and click Export, and we're going to name our texture. We're going to name it Star, and then press Save. Click save. Okay, so after we save the image as JPEG, we are gonna go back to Chloe, okay? So now we are here back into Chloe 3D workspace. We are going to select both of the shoe. To do so, we go to the Select Last Move tool, click on it to activate. And then click on the shoe. First shoe, you click on it to select the other shoe. We're gonna press down shift and then click on it to select. After both of the shoe are selected, come to the property editor panel. And you see below there is basic parameters and under that is texture. To the right side of the texture is a texture swatch. Click on one to open this user clue window. And then you click on the swatch that you saved earlier, which is star. Click on it and then come down here. Click on open. And now, look at, we just changed our shoe color into a star looking pattern. So since both of the heels are black and our color textile also black, we don't have to do anything with them. But if you want to change, let's say you want to change the heel color as well, you just select them and then again Just press on shift and then select another heel, and then repeat the first step to change these heel colors. Right now, look just fine. We don't have to change the heel colors. It looks great. Next, we're going to save the shoe and the avatar so we can use her later. To do so, we are going to file and then save as. And if you look to the right here in this sub menu, you just click on the avatar, okay? And now we're gonna name the avatar. We're gonna name her Kelly with star shoe. Okay? And click save. So now the avatar and the shoes are saved. We're going to close and we're gonna reload the avatar and the shoe. To close, you have two ways to do it. One, you go to file and then click quit to close, or you come over here, you see to the right hand side, you see this X right here to the corner. Just click on X and the close window is closed. Okay, next we're going to reload the avatar. To do so, you double click on close to open. Now close is open. To reload the avatar, we are going to file, and then under the sub menu is add. You hover your mouse over add, and then you see the fly menu over here to the right. Just click on avatar, and after you click on the avatar, this window pop up. It's the user close window, and look for the file that we saved earlier was Kelly with star shoe. So we're gonna click on it to select and click open. And now take a look. So again, guys, press down all and click on your right side of the mouse and drag to the left to see her left view, back view, and you can do the same back to the right. Just press down all and then click on your right side of your mouse to view her in 360 degree. And now as you can see, the avatar have the beautiful star shoe on her. Thanks so much for watching, Designistas. If you guys think this video useful, be sure to subscribe and click on the bell to be notified of future videos. See you for my next tutorials.